Okay, so I'll repeat the question just so that the audience can hear it, and Bo, you can be the first to answer it. So she asked, how can you justify killing plants? So a lot of people don't know this, but plants are conscious, which is the whole reason why plant medicine works, because you're ingesting that the spirit of that plant medicine. So with plants being conscious, and this has been proven through the guy who invented the polygraph machine, where he hooked up sensors to plants and did some experiments and proved that plants were conscious and did have feelings or emotions. So how do you justify killing plants as opposed to the people who kill animals and eat the animals? Well,
thank you for being here. We appreciate you, and we appreciate people having conflicting viewpoints. And like we mentioned earlier, our way doesn't mean that it's the right way. Everybody has stuff to share and learn. But that's a great point. And to mention what Kurtis said, there was tests done. For example, they did this famous test, The Secret Life of Plants. If anybody's read that book before, it seems like you might have. But essentially what the test was is they had these plants in a room, and the guy came in one day and he just hacked this one plant. He pretty much killed it. And then every time that guy would come in the room after that moment, whenever he would walk into the room, the electromagnetic signals that they had hooked up to the plants would spike. And so essentially what they're trying to show is that these plants were conscious of this person coming in. My rebuttal to that statement, though, is that there's plants that they give their gifts to us to consume at the end of their life. So strawberries, for example. The reason why these plants have seeds is because they want mammals like us to eat them, and then they end up coming through our system and going out the other end and becoming planted. So they make them sweet specifically so that we will eat them. So for these plants, it's not the end of their life. It's a gift that they give, and if we don't eat it at the end of the year, it's going to decompose into the ground. It's the circle of life. So that would be my rebuttal to that statement. If you got anything else you wanted to ask me back, I'd love to hear it, and we could talk some more.
I just think it's a choice at the end of the day. I'm not saying being perfect or none of us are, but it's more sustainable at the end of the day. How you've mentioned how much water and grain and et cetera cost to support the farming industry. When you support vegan, you cut that drastically. So it's a choice in that aspect. Just plant, and like you mentioned, plants provide life at the end of the day. If I chop off
all right, we got time for one more.
Is there one up there?
Sure, yeah.
So I really believe that if we get more in tune with feeling and being so in touch that we recognize when something is high vibrational for us and when something is like flat, or it's like we can recognize the truth when we can hear it, and become more sensitive and we're able to read energy. So I can pick up an apple and I can feel that apple is sad. That apple had a sad upbringing. You know, really the person who handled it did not care about it, you know, especially when it's overproduced, you know, and it doesn't grow in soil that's enriched. I can feel that. And so we would be able to choose food and know, like Monsanto or any of these other names that we don't normally name, we would feel that it's not food, that it's plastic. Our body won't be able to integrate it and extract from it the nutrients and the essence that it needs. You know, so plants are alive, and if somebody chooses to care for an animal and take in that animal as part of the conscious cycle, then that's fine if that's their choice. I personally vibrate with plants and fruit, and that essence for me is nourishment. So I think if we all just wake up to our capacity to choose by feeling, if something, we can bless it. I was making fun of Princess Water, like, you can bless it, you know, even though it sounds like a little hippy-dippy. It does, the vibration we put into something changes it. You know, if something was treated poorly, it's not going to hold the same vibration, like Bo was mentioning. And so it's really important for us to take personal responsibility for feeling and waking up our extrasensory abilities.
Okay. All right, we might have one more question, if anyone has a quick question. If not, we're gonna allot. Real quick, if you wanna go down the line and let people know how they can get in touch with you, we'll start with Jen Healy, and then we'll work our way with this one.
Okay, I'm ready, I know this one. So, again, thank you so much, I'm Jen Healy, and I have couple different companies. One of them is called Zen Healing, and Z as in zebra, E-N as in Nancy, and then Healing spelled with a Y-N-G, H-E-A-L-Y-N-G.com. It's Jen Healy, ZenHealing.com. But I also have empowerment tools and transformational trainings that I offer online courses, and you can get a 3-month of empowerment coaching online if you'd like. So you can go to transformationaltraining2017.com, and that'll take you right to the Joy Experience page. Thank you guys so much.
You can find me on multiple social media platforms. I'm mainly on Instagram. My name on there is Stand Up 911 or 911. I host conscious events internationally called Meeting of the Mind. It's pretty much a conscious networking event. We're going to cover a range of topics at full time, vegan food, good music, and meditation as well during the night. And I have a blog called revolutionofmind.org. A lot of great articles on there, information. And yeah, mostly Instagram is my home. I'm also on Facebook as well.
The easiest way to get in contact with me is if you happen to have Instagram. My Instagram is going to be @truth_society. Other than that, you could check out my CBD oil line. If you guys like organic CBD oil, it's something that we produce in Colorado. It's full spectrum. It's definitely helped a lot of people with different ailments. That's going to be New Leaf Naturals, N-U-L-E-A-F, naturals.com. And also, if any of you have anything that you feel you want to share with me or something you can teach me, or if you just want to connect, I'm also going to be out front. So if you want to talk there, you can also connect with me outside. And I thank all you guys for coming again.
I'm Spiritual Heart on Instagram, so you can connect with me there. My website is shamanicfire.com. So if you feel the call to connect me, I'm open. Pretty cool that you all joined us today. It's a beautiful talk, beautiful energy. It's grateful. And we do cosmic consciousness events around California. We're going to be doing one soon. So, Cosmic Consciousness Tribe on Instagram.
Okay, sweet. I'm Kurtis Lee Thomas. I was your moderator for today. You can find me at manfromthestars.com or @manfromthestars on Instagram. So I'm going to close out this panel by, of course, thanking you all for being a part of this on such an important topic. We plan on doing more of them. The final message to everyone is just, don't give up your power. Just think about a present or a gift that we get on Christmas. What's the absolute worst thing that you could do when someone gives you a gift? It's not use it, not open it, or even give it to somebody else. It's truly giving it back to the person that gave it to you. So you have to keep in mind that your gifts, talents, and abilities is God's gift to you. And you using your gifts, talents, and abilities is your gift to God. So as Marianne Williams said, it sucks when my phone died on 2%. I'm like, no, I got this, good memory. Our greatest fear is that we are inadequate beings. Our greatest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. Okay, we're all infinite beings, and I thank you all for being here. So, one last final round of applause to all the panel members. Thank you guys. All right, thank you all.